Start your Orbitype journey by creating a new account. You should have received a verification email in your inbox. Check that now and click the link inside. The button will then change to continue. Next, provide your payment information. You are then ready to create your first workspace. Next, choose the connectors you need. In most cases, you want a database to save entries like blog posts, products, or users, and a bucket for media like images, videos, or documents. Click on continue. Next, if you want to, you can already invite other team members. Simply click on the button and add your email addresses. We will send them invites and automatically add them to your workspace. And you're ready to switch to your workspace. The connectors from before now appear in the sidebar. You have an empty bucket and an empty database. Start by uploading a few files into your bucket. Choose one or more files from your local system and transfer them to Orbitype. Next, create a database table. The Orbitype wizard makes this very easy. Either start from scratch or choose one of the templates. Each template can also be modified. Orbitype supports all common data types. Click on continue, review the SQL code, and click on execute. As you can see, the posts table has been successfully created, and we're ready to add our first row. The Orbitype editor has support for all common data types: plain text, rich text, media files, booleans, and also very complex and deep JSON structures. Let's start by typing out a title for our first blog post, as well as some rich text content. Image fields automatically pick up on your connected buckets. If you click on the folder icon here, you can choose one of the images we've uploaded previously, and it will be linked as the image value of this blog post. If you have JSON columns, you can save any arbitrary JSON object, and Orbitype will automatically generate a GUI for you. This is especially useful if you have developers who wish to store complex data, for example, for their components. Just tell them to switch to the code mode and type in any data they want. Orbitype will automatically handle whatever you throw at it, be it some kind of list or more complex nested objects. Save, return to the tree view, and you as a non-developer now get an intuitive visual representation of this JSON structure. Once you're done, return to the overview using the breadcrumb. As you can see, we have successfully created our first row. To access this data in your own code base, you can use Orbitype's API. Click on Settings and generate a new key. Click on Create, and Orbitype will generate a key that your developers can use in their fetch call to access the data. In a simple example, this looks like this. A simple fetch call to our API, providing the key and the SQL to execute. The data can then be used in any front-end framework to render the content. And this is the result. In this short demo, we've really just scratched the surface of Orbitype's capabilities. The goal of Orbitype is to make things easy, including a lot of other pain points you might be familiar with, like internationalization, that are easily solved by Orbitype. But don't take my word for it. Try it yourself today by signing up on orbitype.com.